लाइव।
डियर फेसबुक प्योर यूरोलॉजी व्यूअर्स, टुडे लाइक एनी अदर इवनिंग 5 o'clock प्रोग्राम वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द थूलियम फाइबर लेजर सक्शन एंड ए बिट ऑफ शीथलेस RIRS. As you all know, retrograde intrarenal surgery last 5 years has picked up the momentum, and usually raised intrarenal pressure is the always concern. At the same time, even if you make small fragments, some fragments may reside inside. So suction and keeping the low pressure within the PCS is one important aspect. Lot of research is going on. Even Dr. Mahesh Desai sir is doing lot of research on Cleopatra, the role of suction in RIRS with a flexible scope without eye on it. That means it is a simple suction with flexion and extension, which goes into the kidney and will suck all the powder blindly under the SIAM guidance. This is the only official entire worldwide research is going on, but not available in the market in India. However, every surgeon in India will get their own ideas to give the better improvement for the patient. Not only in India, all the youngsters will try across the world their innovative methods to do suction and remove the fragments. Even I came to know recently that this APIS Institute, from today's speaker, Dr. Salim Mohammed, he will present today a bit on RIRS, how to do with the thulium fiber laser. Definitely thulium fiber laser has come way forward. I am also convinced. For last 2 years I am using, and most of my cases are done with the thulium fiber laser, and very satisfying, very fast popcorn because of the high frequency. Taking all these to him, I'll introduce our speaker today. I will share my screen to introduce Dr. Salim. So today's session, video based session. RIRS with suction and TFL, how I do, Dr. Salim Mohammed, through the video based presentation. To be honest, I know him more through Facebook and internet. We have not come across directly, but every junior has their own talent, and he is doing a lot of work with thulium fiber laser RIRS, and he feels the current laser of choice is thulium fiber laser, and in future it will replace all the lasers. That is his strong feeling, and a part of the science is also going towards this. I also believe partly that this laser is going to stay for a long time. Dr. Mohammed Salim, MSDNB, consultant urologist and transplant surgeon, currently practicing at the APIS Kidney Clinic, which is located in Kasaragod, Kerala. Chairman, Mangalore Nephro Urology Charitable Trust. His main areas of interest are endourology, uro-oncology, and other urology divisions. He was the assistant professor in the urology department at the Far Muller Medical College, Mangalore. With this introduction, I will hand over the program to Dr. Salim. Over to you, Salim, please.
Good evening, sir. Thank you for this opportunity. I thank the entire team of Pithi Hospital for doing this wonderful job of sharing the surgical technique, whatever the individual person does in their OT to the world. It's a great program, sir, as designed.
Okay, thank you. Proceed, please.
I I'll be talking on the RIRS. The RIRS with TFLDS. What I call this as a new generation RIRS using TFL and dust suction. Why this, I'll let you know in my talks.
Okay, please proceed.
The conventional, I just put it across a point, the conventional RIRS, even though it is there in the field last 15 years, why I didn't adopt. The indication was limited around the largest series or the guidelines says is the 1.5 centimeters upper limit. Definitely there was a pre-stenting stuff use of access sheath, okay, which most of the people in practice don't accept for one. When you take somebody to the stone removal, they want the stone not to have an empty procedure and go ahead. And the fear of instrument damage, when you know, the beginner or when you start with the RIRS program, you have this fear of instrument damage. Once the instrument you invest for a 6-7 lakh scope and it's damaging for the first few cases, that's definitely discouraging. Investment huge for a limited indication. When you say the indications, when it is the limited indication, asymptomatic or symptomatic limited indication, you need to have a separate investment for a beginner or to start the entire program. It is definitely difficult. Flexscope, laser, accessory, what I was talking about, the investment. Patient affordability definitely matters. When the investment goes up, the packages definitely, you know, goes up. Procedure cumbersome with the various pumping stuff, producing extravasation infection, etc. for some time, you know. Non-indicated cases when we advise a patient to undergo because a patient has a stone, or a patient comes with the non-symptomatic patients when they come with the want their stone to be removed. So definitely there are plus minus there. RIRS TFLDS, why I adopted. Here what I felt, the indication, there is no limitation on the stone size. I do from the largest tagon to the routine indicated cases of RIRS without any problem, and I discharge them in a daycare setup. It avoids all kidney punctures in the future. If there's going to be a, you know, mainstream procedure, everybody accepts it, we can avoid any kidney puncture of all kinds, PCNL, mini, micro, supra, PCNL, any. The wider indication is going to be wider here. I put it forward in this format. When there's the open surgery, then comes the PCNL, and the future would be RIRS, TFLDS. When you do a TFL RIRS and a dust suction, the scenario is going to be totally different. How it is different from, the routine, it avoids the access sheath. I'll put across each point one video following, where conventional RIRS, you need to have an access sheath most of the time. Working always in a lower interrenal pressure, this is the key of factor of all the RIRS surgeons, what they are bothered about. Here, definitely because of suction, you're working in a very low interrenal pressure. Intermittently, its entire pressure interrenal is under surgeon's control. Working in an infectious system, when I don't suggest infection system, means it's not a pus. It is the debris which there in the initial, when entering to the PCS, can be suctioned out and you can proceed with the procedure. Get into the system with the cleaning division as you go, debris, as I mentioned. And working if possible, I do under a gravity irrigation without no pump. Okay. And we are proceeding with this, whatever this thing, I'm designed a new product which is going to come in market in 1 month time. That is, we are very, very, you know, beautiful product, which is a lot of adjustment. The RIS agent's going to love it. Dust suction, it helps in cleaning vision and going it with the procedure, the largest stones. And definitely during the procedure, dust suction going to help us to assess the residual stones. And definitely, I put forward a concept of visual imaging. The follow-up patients can be during the stent removal. Just remove the stent, we can go inside and no need to take the patient through any imaging modality. I mean, radiological imaging modality. We can just look into the PCS, the visual imaging, for 100% clearance. This procedure is going to take the entire RIS program towards a 100% stone-free rate. Just coming to my series, just to put across the volume of you know, the work what we do, it is a multiple stones. You can see this one large stone in the pelvis, one in the last one in the superior calyx. And clearance after 1 month, the same stone. And there's a chakar iris, what I do. You can see the same calyceal point. There is no calculus. And system is perfectly, you can see the virgin system like PCS at 1 month. Few more stones. I can see the volume of stones. The Hounsfield units projected. These all stones are managed with the RIRS. This is a complete stack one. I managed in 3 sittings. And this is how it is getting collected in the, you know, end of the procedure. You get that dust section in bottle. You can see. I put it across the word dust art pig. The future is going to be, all the surgeons are going to come up with this bottles in their Twitter account, in their WhatsApp account, whatever. The beauty of the surgeon gets the stone ahead of the RIRS procedure would be the best thing RIRS surgeon will dream about. You can see the lot of I put it as a dust art, because the various the weight of the fragment, the size of the fragment, dust makes it a different various pattern in the dust collection in the bottle, and you can see the various pattern which is happening in the inside the bottle. You can call whatever name. It can be called as, you know, desert sand pattern or whatever. With that indications and the final result, I mean, that stone, when any patient pays for the procedure, they want the end result is a stone in stone treatment. This is the format we can give the stone to the patient, and the various dust art, you can see how beautifully it is seen. It's all naturally settled down pattern. I'm not patterning it. It's a settled down pattern by itself. As coming to the techniques, the no axis sheath. I don't use the axis sheath at all in this thing. Axis sheath is modified into a concept of a scope straightener, which is coming as an organized product in 2 months' time. The scope straightener concept is like, you know, you are bypassing the urethra with the axis sheath, the mini axis sheath kind of thing, which is remains at the trigone. And you can move the scope into the VUJ like a rigid scope. That is concept, I call it as a rigiflex concept, how the flexible scope is used as a rigid scope. I mean, a rigid flexible scope is used as a format of a rigid scope. There's a rigiflex concept. The access to the urethra, you can see the video. The pre-stented ureters can be entered without any. This is the end of the procedure. I just recorded to show the access into the ureter. The, you know, how freely we can enter without the guide wire, without any access sheath. When you enter into the VJ, there are 2-3 scenarios. As we enter in a rigid scope, you know, with the guide wire or without the guide wire, or sometimes you get that edematous VJ. The all the cases you can enter with the in flexi scopes, I'm using most of the time 7.5 endoscope. With that, we can negotiate the VUJ without any problem. The next one is with the guide wire in. As you enter with the, as you enter in a, you know, rigid scope, how you enter the VUJ with the guide wire. These are not the, these are the primary ureters without pre-stenting. the little bit of manipulating at the VUJ with the outflow totally closed. Keep that increases the pressure of the VUJ and to enter in the ureter. This you can see the ureter, you know, guide wires getting, you know, coiled inside the ureter, which can be the removed and directed like this thing. I call this as a visual guide wire, because without guide wire, most of the time, any kink in the ureter, we can negotiate and go. This is something like, you know, the 7.5 scopes acts as a visual guide wire. With the miniaturizing of these scopes and this TFL and the dust section, the RIRS, the future RIRS is going to change.
Do you pre-stent in all cases?
No. It is something like that. No pre-stenting at all. It goes in like indication of this is another primary case. Like, you know, direct entry into the VUJ without pre-stenting. It remains, indication going to remain like in a rigid scope. Most of the time, rigid scope, what you have indication, like, you know, some narrow tight ureter, which is otherwise definitely anybody can't do anything. You have to stent and come. It steps down to that much of indication. Now, like initially, it was 95%. Now, like after doing around 100, 120 cases, now like 99% of the time, I don't do pre-stenting.
On the other way around, my incidence of stenting has increased from 10% to 20% now, because I don't
do 95% of no this thing too. It has come down to 99% because of 7.5 scope.
But this is not 7.5. This is only tip 7.5. Must be
yeah. This is another edematous VUJ. You can see the edematous VUJ. I am entering like a rigid scope.
Yeah.
You can see the amount of edema
there. You have not damaged any scope so far?
No, I am using more hours. 30 hours, I am using 45 hours. I will tell you how to use that later, the next session maybe. The clearing division, coming to the next the video, as I mentioned, as we go on doing the RIS, the end of the system, inside system, we're going to get some debris. We can see how we can clear with the dust suctioning.
Where are you applying the suction?
Pardon, sir?
Where are you applying the suction?
Suction is through the scope, sir.
Flexible scope?
Through the flexible scope.
What is the attachment? Can you show?
Attachment, I didn't put the end of the show. I'll show you. Okay.
Because let that us, is the important. Where pardon, you are sir? Attaching, what you are attaching, how much you are doing suction, which suction mission, and how you grade the suction.
Yeah, I mean, Chandamo sir, I'll discuss on that, because that is a key factor. I'm coming up with the complete product. So with the one, this thing, there is a little bit of copyright stuff. Okay. Because in 1 month time, the entire product is going to be in market. Okay. Because we have redefined from the conventional method what I did. I'll show you the connections to you later. Okay. Now I'm just showing the videos, how much effective we are able to do that. Clinically. You can see how the system gets clean. Can I appreciate, sir?
Yeah, but I wanted to see the stone first, how you powdered, what laser settings, and after that, how you sucked, because the lumen is 7.5 French only.
Yeah, I'm coming to that. I'll just go to that video first.
Yeah.
You want me to go to that video first?
First, you should show the lumen.
Yes.
No problem.
I'm coming to this.
Yeah.
I do a fixed setting. I work on a, so you can listen to me.
Yeah, I'm audible. Tell the frequency and settings of the popcorn, what you are doing.
No, no. I work on a fixed setting. My setting is this: from the starting point to the end point, I do a dash.
Hello? Hello? Salim? We are not able to hear you, Salim.
Hello?
Salim, we are Hello? Not able to hear you.
It's clear now?
Yeah. What are the fixed settings?
Yeah, I work on a fixed setting. I work on a fixed setting, 0.1 into 100 hertz and 2 into 7.5 fragmentation. And one thing you have to see in this video, what I do is I don't press on the dusting. I press on the fragmentation.
That's okay. Why fixed settings? We use a variety of settings. This is a laser with versatile setting ranges.
Yeah, that is true. But what I've realized, this setting saves my fiber to the maximum. It's quite economical setting. I don't need to change into the popcorn mode, anything. With this, I finish my procedure with this fixed setting, which I analyze over the time. See, increases the power. That's a more of fiber consumption. If this setting is gives my friendly, fragmentation, dusting, everything happens.
What is the energy and frequency setting?
Sir?
Energy and frequency setting.
Yeah, it's a 2 frequency and 7.5 in this thing, 15 watts fragmentation. 0.1 into
200 frequency.
Pardon?
How much is the frequency?
In fragmentation, 7.5. In dusting, it is 100.
What is the energy?
Energy. Total energy comes to 10 watt in dusting and 15 watt in fragmentation. Hello?
Yeah.
I'll proceed with the thing.
Yes.
You can see always my mode of working is a fragmentation. I don't press on the dusting.
Have you ever used popcorning?
No, I'll come to that. Popcorning, how we can avoid it? You can just see. No, popcorning, I use it, but visual, when that vibration goes up, that it goes towards a more of a blind stuff. So this suction prevents that, and till the last, you can see this video, I'm just doing with the fragmentation mode and the suction in between. And the entire this thing, till the end of this thing, dusting and clearing of the dust, it will be under vision.
What happens if the dust gets stuck in your lumen of the scope?
No, till now it's not that happened, but initial when I was using 9.1 fragment, large fragment was stuck. I fired inside the scope. It is a disposable scope. Nothing happens inside the scope. One, twice it was a failure, little bit, but the scope was saved and nothing happened to scope. I completed the total limited hour scope time. You can see that dust suctioning happening. That I called as a storming in phenomena, wherein that snow stock kind of phenomena that's getting sucked inside the loop. You feel like it's a popcorn kind of action.
You try with popcorn. It will become much finer dust and you can suck it better, I'm telling you.
Yeah, definitely. But what happens during the popcorning, what I says,
in popcorn, if you keep 0.25 joules and 100 hertz, vision will not be lost. Beautiful. This machine is known for popcorn.
Okay. Then I'll try it next time.
I might have used more than 1,000 cases last 2 years. I'm the first person to buy this machine in India. More than 1,000 cases I have done. You try popcorn also. Don't mind. You are also doing good work here. We will exchange the knowledge. This is the idea.
Definitely. I'll try with that also. How it difference? Definitely, sir. Point taken, sir. No problem. What I felt like the frequency as it increases, the entire bubbling happens to the scope tip.
That will not happen, but 100. If you cross more than 200, it will happen.
Yeah. I popcorn at 250, so that's a problem.
No, 100, 150 you keep.
Okay.
This we are able to appreciate a nice powder. And you might have shown how intermittently external view, even though the petals are with you only, then people might have appreciated that. What is
that? I have a video at the end of the thing. I'll just change out and show you. Don't worry. Yeah,
it must, because that is what we wanted to show.
Definitely.
Are you using the suction, normal suction, which we use in the theater for abdominal suction?
Not the normal
open
suction.
Open surgery suction or anything else?
I'll show you the reduction picture also. It is not the normal suction. It is a small pressure suction, which is used for the phlegmons. And I put a picture in my Twitter in the beginning when I was this thing, that everything is there in the Twitter, this thing.
We can fast forward this a little bit, because it is showing the same picture. Yeah.
You can see the clearance.
Yeah.
Almost, this is a dream, this thing to clear. That little bit of mucosa, this thing is get sealed without any problem. I do keep doing chakra rest. Nothing happens. There's a little bit of mucosal injuries. That is nicely at 1 month's time.
The concept is very good. Normal flexible scope, you are doing suction. It is definitely good. If you make fine powder, that will get disappeared. And the rest of the fragments can be again fragmented and again can be sucked intermittently.
It so was nearly 99.9% dust suction at the... This is the end picture.
Yeah. So you are applying suction to the 3.4 French channel.
3.6
channel, you will suck.
Yes.
With the laser in situ.
Yes, with the laser in situ. You can see there is firing and suctioning simultaneously.
And you will have two channels, one channel for the laser and one channel for the suction. Flushing and suction, you will use the same channel.
Hello?
Flushing and suction, you will use the same channel?
Yeah, same channel. I'll show you the connection and how it is done. Okay, irrigation stops, suction, ask for a suction. When suction is happening, irrigation stops. And the laser fibers remains in the center channel without removing it.
Yeah, laser fiber, no problem. For suction and irrigation, you have two ports or one Y junction you use or single junction?
It is a irrigation in one channel and the suction in the another channel. Irrigation in the down channel.
It's a Y junction.
Not the Y junction. It's a straight this thing in the two right angle, this thing. Three-way connector. We vertically connect one channel to the opposite each. It's like just a rigid fix concept. What we have in a rigid channel. In and
I
out.
Got the point.
Yeah.
I got the point.
I'll show you the video. I'll share you the video in person later if you want. Okay. Now, one more video. Continue the video. How does this suction helps in bringing the stone close? The calcium system moves close to the scope. It not necessarily bend the scope. There's an inferior calyx stone. Sometimes you can move the stone close to the scope tip and we can do the work.
Yeah, that is important point. I agree with that.
Yeah,
because sometimes the calcium
and another
the
point
calcium cupping will be deep.
Hello.
Yeah, please.
Yes, inferior calyx stone no need to reposition with this technique most of the time. And basketing with the suction assistant also is possible. I'll show you the video for these three things. This is a patient, just a small stone, but you can see it's an emergency patient who had AKI with the single kidney. present 2 years back with the proximal stone is stented and could not clear this stone. Again, he comes back after 2 years with the same process, the proximal stone. I did the URS, the stone migrated up. I had equipment this time, so I am entering primarily at the VUJ without access sheath in this patient. You can see the entry.
Yeah.
Yes. And inside the system, after debris are washed, this is the inferior calyx stone I am seeing and fragmenting it.
Do you have the CM picture of this?
No, sir. Fluoroscopy use has come down to nearly 99% down. Fluoroscopy also nowadays, you know, because of this this thing, fluoroscopy, SOS I use. Because what I was like, can I use
the...
No. I'm
asking fluoroscopy, the angle of the flexion which you are showing.
Yeah. I have the suction angle video is there. Suction is possible in all angle. I'll just show you that. I have video for that, suction acting in all the angle. This is just to show that movement of the calyx and suction assistant in basketing and the... I just forward it.
You should edit and keep in separate videos. It will be more effective because single video is always risky.
Yes. Actually, it was
any fast, any fast forward, sometimes it may not play entire thing again.
Yes.
Definitely, even in upper calyx, when the deep calyceal cupping is there, suction will get the stone into your view. That is for sure.
Definitely. And this you can see, the calyx in emptying and moving close to your scope.
Yeah, yeah. The what is the mode of your irrigation?
It is a gravity irrigation. We have that arthroscopy irrigation side. Simple with that, you get that arthroscopy irrigation side. No pumping and all. It's a gravity irrigation.
And
elastics. Definitely elastics also helps in.
This is what recently Vikram has presented.
Yeah, I mean, I've been using that for all my upper aortic stones. Same thing, you know, no retrograde irrigation. It is inlet closed, lancix, and outlet open most of the time. The same function, you know, applies here also. Can see the calyx moving closer to the fiber with the suction. So I wanted 100%, so I didn't want to completely touch here. I just to show this, you know, basketing can assist, you know, for this video purpose. I wanted to you can see here the dust get closer to the
What is the basket you are using?
Basket, it is Indovasio 2.4 wire. You can see here, the fragment moves first, then the basket goes into the... you can see the fragment going to the suction. Pardon, sir?
It is encircle basket?
Yeah, encircle basket. 4 wire, 2.4 French. I use without sheath. I remove the sheath, and without sheath, I put the basket. Basket and laser fiber remains in the scope all the time. I use it SOS when it's required. You can see this. You saw that suction moving the fragment first, and then the basket getting the fragment in there. Because it is a primary obstructed case, the vision is poor in the other callus. You can just see the basket goes in, the fragment suction first, then the basket holds it. You can see the suction fragment moving into the scope first. Appreciate, sir?
Yeah.
Suction, next point is the suction is possibly not calyxes. You can see the screen suction happening and the inferior calyx. That's the last video clearance at the end of the procedure. This is suction in all the calyces. 1 minute, just there's a short segment in that. This is a screen showing the suction, and the you can see the fluoroscopy. It is almost in the inferior calyx band. It is suctioning at that calyces also. Coming to the techniques, what the way you can do the suction. One thing is I'm saying the simultaneous suction. Another thing is. We can, at the end of the procedure, these are the volume radiological videos already I have presented in our thing. This you can see, at the end of the procedure, you want to remove all the things and do the suction. It's a 50 over the mucosa. You can see clearly how the suction, I mean, gets suctioned into the scope.
We usually use syringe to suck this fine dust and then clear, and later on attach the pump. Later on attach the
this everything happens syringe. Simultaneously through the scope. There's another.
We use.
You can see how the pieces get clean with this, you know. Maximum volume of dust is dust gets suctioned in this.
Do you have any staghorn case?
Yes, sir. Here, 1 minute. I'll show you the.
What is the computer you are using?
Pardon?
What is the PC you are using? Laptop?
No, which company? It's compared. I'm outside actually. So in emergencies, I use mobile only now. You can see this staghorn. Saw this?
Yeah. Not staghorn, but a high volume stone.
Pardon?
Yeah, high volume stone.
Yeah.
How much time it took?
It took 3 hours. I work most of the time on the spinal, 3 to 4 hours. This patient had a follow-up after 1 month, small fragment left out, which is removed on the same day and sent removed, evening discharge. That's the two sittings, everything's done. A few more things. Another technique of suction would be like, as I'm doing other videos, a simultaneous suction. This is simultaneous suction with the fiber in situ, as I showed in the initial video also. Can see this common phenomena, the towards the working channel, the dust getting suctioned inside. Another video must have seen into this fragment repositioning, which is another benefit here. Without basketing, suction itself, we can reposition the stone fragments. Technique is, suction inside, drop into the superior calyx, stop the irrigation there. No, don't irrigate, because this fragment is to move from there down. If you irrigate there, then bring down and drive to the suction. Scope itself lifting the fragments.
Okay. So we are already 40 minutes. Can we wind up? Can you make a summary of this?
Yes, sir. Last this thing. The another was the multiple instrumentation can be used. Compared to the one minute, the slide. I propose it as an open PCNL, and the new, this will be a RIS TFLDS, which is going to come up in this year. If everybody adopts that suction technique, we will definitely try avoiding the kidney punctures. I just had a comparison video with the benefit here. Yeah, conventional procedure, we have three procedures most of the time. Here, most of the time, you have a two procedure with the visual clearance at, check RLS and remove the stent. 2 to 3 days hospitalization in the conventional RIRS, we have near 100% stone free rate in TFL, and most of the time daycare procedure, I discharge the patient 12 hours. And fluoroscopy, definitely yes, in conventional RIRS, near no fluoroscopy at present my practice, and there is no limitation of stone size, what I feel. Last 1 year, I have not done the PCNL except for the one case, which was the forgotten stent, which had a superior calyx incrustation in the infundibulum, so we could not pull it out, so need to go for a kidney puncture. Last 1 year, I've done one PCNL after adopting this. So an average urologist like me and who started the program 1 year can make a difference with you know, such a large volume stone with RIRS, definitely it'd be easy learning with this technique for any newcomer, new fellow who want to adopt on the RIRS. Learning curve will be very, very minimal in this.
Okay. So should we conclude with that?
Yes, sir.
Prashant, can you so for all the viewers, thank you, Dr. Salim, for giving an innovative thought. To conclude, see, what he is saying is he is using 7.5, so-called the tip flexible scope. It is not 77.5 for the audience. It does not go through the 9x11.5 axis sheath. But as Salim said, he is passing without sheath in all the cases. A small amount of caution for the juniors. So with the experience of 15 years, whenever you do any scopy in the ureter, remember, do a check scopy with a 6x7.5 ureteroscope. That is what the size of the ureter normally should be there.
Yeah, if my you practice, pass, sir, excuse me. My practice starts with the rigid scope, 100%.
That you have not mentioned. I am concluding. Give me. I am concluding. What are all the things the juniors must take is always assess the ureter. Never feel hesitant to see the ureter. It is nobody in the world said that without stenting I can do all the cases of RIRS. One must not use 100% without stent I can put RIRS. It is not correct. Lot of literature says that 5 to 10% of the cases ureters will not accommodate any type of scope. We all know that. As Salim mentioned in his talk nicely, that sometimes when the ureter is tight, we cannot do anything. That you have to anticipate. And the second thing is, when you go with this, when you go with the flexible scope inside, Prashant, can you stop the sharing the screen? When you go into the ureter, when you have any stones multiple, if you have a single stone, you can do, there are various methods of lithotripsy settings. No setting is permanent, no setting is correct, no setting is wrong. Variety of settings is there. One day, one surgeon says that he uses highest energy and lowest frequency to do under spinal. Other surgeon says that I use only one setting for all the cases. Whereas we say that there are versatile settings for the hard stone, for the popcorn, for the dusting, for the fragmentation. Machine has been given for wide variety of settings. So we should follow, we should see in all angles. Tomorrow I will also try this single setting. We usually try 1 and 10 for fragmentation mode and 0.25 and 100 for the popcorn. When you use popcorn, normally the powder will go into the so small with TFL. When you take out the scope, it will come out through the access sheath because we use access sheath. Instead, here we are using the suction. Very good idea, where all the dust will come out. The only worry I have as the experienced person is that if any smaller fragments get sucked into the scope and clog inside, then it is a problem, in which case the laser fiber has to be taken out. If this happens by the side of the access sheath with all of us, when the access sheath is in the ureter, when the flexible scope is in the PCS, lot of powder and dust come by the side of the access sheath. There are case reports where outer access sheath is peeled off. Similarly, in a disposable scope, it may be cost effective, but the small amount of the dust may clog inside when you are doing suction. That is the one point we wanted to know in future from Dr. Salim. The last point which I wanted to mention is that there is no way it is written that Siam no technique. That is, has to be, we have to be very careful in a teaching forum. Every junior must understand that all the endourological procedures without Siam don't do the case. Whether it is a easy case, whether it is a difficult case, when you go with flexible scope, particularly multiple stones, for example, we are doing a study where if you go to calyces without Siam, you will see 90%, but you may miss 10%. But if you inject contrast, one or two additional calices you may go, but that additional calices may not have the stone. In that case, there is no need to see them. But if you have stone, if you have multiple stones, if you have a complex system, if you have a bifid system, do not hesitate to use the SIAM. Without SIAM, do not attempt the RIRS casually. This is a going to be a very important point today. SIAM has to be there in all the cases of PCNL, all the cases of URSL, all the cases of RIRS, because you don't know where, how you get struck in each case. That is one point. But when tomorrow, this idea of this surgical technique is that we have started looking at Dr. Vikram Sridharan under spinal anesthesia because it is COVID season. Now, tomorrow only, I will try this suction within, if in fact Salim, if he has shown the suction apparatus outside and the vertical, this one, at least one peak. I know it is maybe patent reasons he is not showing, but people love to see if I attach directly suction to the 3.4, 3.6 channel of the flexible scope, what is the connector of the suction? How you both, for example, how each person like suction and the flushing person, how they coordinate, how they, two persons are required or two brains are required to flush, to suck, to flush, to suck. Both will not happen at a time naturally because one is forward flow, another is reverse flow. These points we will come to listen again from Salim in the future once he does the patency. Definitely this type of innovation, for example, Shah suction sheath in PCNL is going to be a very useful one. Similarly, I think Salim will come out something with suction. One definitive use I am feeling in this case with my experience is there are a deep cupped calices will be there. When you make fragments, all the fragments will go, even though it is single calyx, into the deep calyceal fornices. They won't come out. The scope at the tip will not bend to the small fragments. In that case, if you apply fraction of second suction, as he said, they all come to the center of the scope, and again you can apply the laser or you can apply the suction directly. This will be the very, very important point I have learned today. So with this, we have already made 50 minutes of presentation. I must appreciate, because it is easy to tell the negatives of a innovative techniques over a period of time. I must feel that this guy is going to come out with something new in RIRS and his dreams will come out. He is continuously persisting on that. Definitely he will succeed. With this, we will conclude the session. I congratulate Salim. Keep going on whatever may be the negatives. When we have started with the access sheath insertion method with the rigid ureteroscope without SIAM, lot of controversy like 10 years back I have this much. We all have to publish the papers. We have to write scientific content. We don't mind associated with you. And in future, let us make into scientific paper, then entire world will accept these type of innovations from India. So with this, I conclude the session. I thank you, Salim, for giving and valuable time for sparing for this presentation. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Over to Prashant. Thank you, Salim.
Thank you, sir.